importance of the necessary interventions and the support needed for the delivery of numeracy, and not only the veteran council but all of our institutions. I want you to encourage you to work with your students, encourage you to support the efforts of management. It shows that you have a vision for your students, and that vision is in keeping with the vision of the Ministry of Education. And we can only get better if we work close together. Students, you have a responsibility. The institution loves you. Why I'm saying so is evident in what activities and initiatives are undertaken to support you. I want you to show your appreciation to the principal, the staff, and all the stakeholders who would have brought you this far. I want you to be focused, to be respectful, to give praises to your teachers for all that they are doing for you. Acknowledge what is done. And I know they would be happy for me to say to you that to work with them, not to work counter to them. Your future is also your responsibility. And if you work with the institution, you would realize your dreams and your aspirations for the future. Karen, if you are here again, we are also encouraging you to work with the school, work with your students, so that at the end of the day, what is delivered from the better high school will be quality education that you desire. So again, on behalf of the Ministry of Education, we want to say thank you to the Mustang Charter Trust and to the principals, students and staff of the institution for these two worldwide initiatives, and we continue to have with you to ensure that quality education is delivered to the students and the management and the residents. Thank you.
Project that's come to fruition.
$31. And we spent on equipment almost $19,000. And the rest of the money, a second grant was given, because the trustees said to me, you know, Lavinia, it's wonderful to have renovated and retrofitted this lunchroom, but how is the school going to pay for the meals? So we applied again from behalf of the school, and we were able to get further grants for just around, I think it was nearly $6,000 for the running of the, I think we, it was $5,985 that was asked for, and this is, Pompey was able to get that. And we'd like to thank also, because the cost of running the school meal program was nearly $14,000. So the trust contributed nearly $6,000, and one of the reasons that the trustees approved this part of the grant so quickly was that the school had gone out and solicited a lot of donations. So congratulate yourselves. People want to support Bethel High School, so congratulations. So we must be charitable trustees, please, that Bethel High School has now joined our school meal program, so that we now have 8 schools having a school meal program, and the focus is to provide a nourishing meal. We know you all like chicken and chips, but there is food beyond that, and we want to make sure that you get the right food that's going to help you in your studies. And the principals in the schools where we have these programs have reported that with this support from the trust, attendance, behavior, and academic performance has improved. So to go back to that word difference, we will be checking with the school to, in fact, make sure that attendance, behavior, and academic performance has improved, and we enjoy sharing in your successes with you. We'd also like to thank other persons who've been involved with the transformation of the classroom into a lunchroom. The carpentry department in the prison services were also involved, and the trust was pleased to give support to this rehabilitation work at this institution. And in the not too distant future, you will be hearing how the Mustique Charitable Trust is going to be helping these very disadvantaged persons who are outside society and are in the prisons, and the trust is going to be running programs to try to rehabilitate them into society. So we hope that this support will assist the students at risk who will now be in a better position to achieve their academic potential. I read with interest your mission statement, which is to provide a favorable teaching and learning environment and developing knowledge, skills, attitudes that adequately prepare learners to become responsible, productive citizens in an ever-changing world. I think this encapsulates what the trust
marks the culmination of years of planning and fundraising to establish a mathematics room at the Bethel High School. The idea was born a few years ago when Mr. Carson Ferdinand, who is now retired, headed the mathematics department. The aim was to create a room specifically for the enhancement of the teacher learning experience in mathematics at our school. We realized that students needed a hands-on approach to many of the concepts taught in the classroom, which would enable them to apply their problem-solving skills to real-life situations. Student-centered learning is one of our main focus areas in the Effective School Principals Initiative mentioned earlier by Mrs. Pompey. A math room will serve to facilitate teacher techniques that will foster student-centered learning, as well as provide support for the teaching of mathematics towards numeracy, all of which will contribute towards the achievement of our major goal, which is to ensure that our students are well equipped to function effectively in the world of work. We take this opportunity to thank the management of the school for sharing our vision and supporting this project. We are grateful to the staff and students for supporting our fundraisers. I particularly wish to express heartfelt gratitude to the members of the mathematics department for the hard work they have put into this venture, and to publicly thank Ms. Taker Charles, that she doesn't want me to do this, but I'm doing it. I want to publicly thank her, that she's a member of the Maths Department. She was charged with the responsibility of enhancing the appearance of the room, and she has done an excellent job. Thank you, Ms. Charles, and thank you all for listening.
got you.
Let us pray. There, Father, we are so thankful. Thank you for your goodness, your mercy. Thank you for your blessing, our Lord. We do thank you for all persons who have put into this venture. We pray that you continue blessing them from them, against each other, the family, trust, and all partners who partner with this school. You bring this mushroom in your hand. I ask you, Lord God, that you bless it. Continue to favor those who are leading and bless the students as they come. We pray that it be a blessing to them and their parents. Provide for them. We know that you are a great provider. And so we have to provide. Now we place this lunchroom in your hand. And we pray that you bless the corners, the doors, and everything within this room. We place it in your hand. I hereby dedicate this room to the honor and glory of your name. In the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Blessed Holy Spirit. Now, Father, in Jesus' name, use this room for the honor and glory of your great name. This is my prayer to Jesus Christ, Lord.
Amen.
I now declare the mass room officially open.
Our great God and our Father, we thank you for the vision of those persons we have given a vision, and you have said we told a vision that we will perish. But God, we thank you for this vision. We thank you for the venture. We pray, God, for the teachers, and we pray for the student. We pray that through this smart room, God, effective learning will take place in this room. We pray that the children and students will focus, and we pray for success.
Yes.
Lord, we pray that those who are going to teach or lecture within this room, we give them a special skill.
Yes.
Not skill. Wisdom. Oh God, to execute what you have placed into their hand, into their mind, into their spirit. That God, at the end of every session, the student will move from this room, and as they go through the door, Lord, they'll be filled with learning, and all the math's problems will solve. No, God, I place this room in your hand. Use it to the honor and glory of your name. Let your blessing flow in this place. We pray for attention, that the children and student will give perfect attention to the teachers as they were taught in the school. Lord, let your blessing flow as the waters cover the sand. Not only the student bless, but bless the teachers also. Give them good health. Oh God, even the time when the student is pushing them to the limit, give them that self-restraint. Give them, God, the self-discipline that God will be that model that you want them to be. Now I place the entire school and the matron in your care and dedicate it to the honor and glory of your name. This is my prayer today, in Jesus Christ.
Amen.